In this video, I will tell you all about the prevention and treatment of acne on TRT.
Please like and subscribe. Thank you.
So, how does testosterone replacement therapy lead to the formation of pimples? It all comes down to dehydrotestosterone, or DHT. DHT is a hormone that is produced by your body from testosterone. It's actually 5 times more potent than testosterone, and it plays a vital role in your sexual development and health. When young men are going through puberty, their bodies produce a lot of DHT in order to encourage the growth of their reproductive organs. DHT also causes your body to produce more skin oils, and oily skin is one of the primary causes of acne. The sebaceous glands contain most of the steroidogenic enzymes for the conversion of DHEA into testosterone and DHT. We even notice androgen-induced acne more often in people taking DHEA as a supplement than in people on testosterone. So, it's no surprise that TRT increases the risk of acne. TRT is basically flooding your body with testosterone, which is then converted to DHT. The potent hormone increases the production of skin oil, which in turn increases your risk of developing pimples. The P. acne bacteria already live on your skin, speeding up the rate at which your skin cells die off. Mix the dead skin cells with the increase in skin oil, and you have a TRT-fueled recipe for acne. Of course, there are other factors at play. There are genetic factors. People that tend to have dry skin, atopic skin, or even eczema, dermatitis, are less prone to develop acne and puberty as well as on TRT. Stress plays a big role as well, since more stress leads to more cortisol, which is known to cause acne breakouts as well. For some, nutritional factors play a role, especially if you're sensitive to taking in dairy products. For others, not so much. It seems logic that hygienic factors are also important, since the more sebum you can remove from your skin regularly by using the right detergents, the less acne you'll probably develop. Wear clean shirts every day. Wash your bed sheets once every week. Shower daily and immediately following a workout to keep pores unclogged. The job that you do can also influence acne breakouts. If your job requires you to work with oily, greasy hands and you're touching your face several times a day, you see how that could lead to acne problems. The same goes for the work environment and air conditioning you're working in. Think dry and cool air versus hot and humid. And last factor, the pore blocking tendency of the TRT gels, especially on the shoulders, if you're using topical products, of course. A lot of men rubbing these TRT gels get really bad acne breakouts, very localized to that area. So, you want to get rid of the pimples or prevent your TRT treatment from causing an outbreak. First thing that can be done, if you're having serious cystic acne outbreaks, is reducing the TRT dose. Of course, T levels in the blood have to be monitored and kept in range, as well as the low T symptoms that have to be eliminated, which is the whole point of being on TRT in the first place. Since nutrition and hygiene can be factors at play, switch to cleaner eating, if you haven't already, and wash off excess sebum with a good anti-acne soap regularly. These soaps are often made with benzoyl peroxide and salicylic acid, two highly effective anti-acne treatments. Ideally, you should shower right after a heavy workout and use the soap to wash your face and any body parts where there is an acne breakout. As food supplements, try vitamin B5 or pantothenic acid, which is needed by your body to keep the fatty acid production under control. So, it decreases the skin oil production. Recommended doses are 3 times 750 mg a day. Another supplement is zinc, one of the most important minerals for a healthy body. Zinc ensures that your bloodstream carries sufficient vitamin A to the skin, and it helps to regulate the cellular apoptosis, death, of your skin cells. By ensuring that your skin cells die at a healthy rate, zinc essentially prevents the buildup of dead skin cells that soaks up skin oil to clog your pores. Recommended doses are 20 to 30 mg a day. L-carnitine is an amino acid that helps enhance the metabolism of fats and oils, which ultimately reduces excess sebum produced by the skin. Less sebum means less food for acne-causing bacteria, which means less acne. Recommended doses are 3 times 250 mg a day. Concerning topical medication, Typically, topical antibiotics like erythromycin is used, as well as topical retinoids, sometimes in combination. Systemic medication for acne are typically oral antibiotics like tetracycline or limicycline. Isotretinoin or Accutane is one of the most potent prescription treatments to cure acne. It's usually used to treat cystic acne, which is a much more serious form of acne that is likely to cause scarring. The treatment is effective in up to 85% of cases. However, be aware that the medication does come with side effects and it may lower testosterone levels. Consult your physician before mixing TRT and isotretinoin. I hope you found this video helpful. If so, give it a thumbs up, share it with others and leave a comment or question under the video.